Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Accident. It's Jay. And today we are going to do the next couple accidents in the dossier, if you will. So this one's going to be in Leningradskaya Oblast, Russia. Something to do with a snowstorm on March 4th. Oh, this one's in the future. At 2:20, the first responder was Oleg. I'm not even gonna try, and yeah, we're not even gonna try those. So, let's go ahead and do this. So I feel like this one kind of speaks to stuff going on in this country right now, since like everybody has snow, and people don't know how to drive in the snow. So let's slow down. Be careful in the snow. Oh my. Service. Awesome. So I gotta figure out how to call emergency services now. Oh, damn, I thought that closed the door. All right, well, we can't call emergency services from there. What is this? To see if there was like a phone box somewhere. Still no service. Wait, there's something over here. That I can't get to. Alright. Mm-hmm. Breathing. Saw that coming. Okay. We're doing a lot better this time. Sir, can you hear me? Good, he's still breathing. I wants me to check on this third victim, but I don't know that we can get the third victim. Can we break a window? Window switch. All right, good. Everyone's breathing. Always put on gloves. Oh God, this is where we die. Don't hit me. Ah, thank God. She's not gonna make it. Come on, Jason, get back to your car. Close the trunk. Didn't realize I had to click the wait for help button. All right, now it's time to gather the evidence. So I'm guessing, yep, all the roads are shut down. So that's. right, so we got all of our clues. Let's see if we can pick them up, put them together here. So, all right, so loses control of his car while changing lanes. Collides with Michigan's car. Spins around and slams into a tree. Michigan is able to control the slide and get himself into the parking lot. He slams on the brake, which locks up all the wheels and crashes his car into a parking shed. Hey. Look at that. I'm an accident investigator. Good for Igor. During the accident, Lesya suffered only minor injuries. Unfortunately, due to her advanced age and overall poor health, her recovery was slow and problematic. With the support of her husband and their children, she left the hospital a few months. Vadim's head injury wasn't the most serious threat of his life. Colliding with the tree crushed several of his ribs, which caused a lot of internal damage, including a punctured lung. Most of these were treated at the hospital, but a long recovery time meant he had to close his business. All right. So there's a successful crash investigation in Russia. Ooh. Our phone's ringing. Hi, how's the work going? Our invaluable Amy has finished 3 more cases. They're already on your desk, Mark. Thanks, Mark. All right. And Sweden, France, or, ooh, you know what? Let's do Tennessee. Let's do something in the U.S. here. When deciding who to help, think about whose life is the most threatened. That's called triaging. I wonder if alcohol is going to be a factor in this crash. That looks like a Charger. That's sad. I don't think it is. Might be an Audi. I don't know. It's hard to tell. It's pretty banged up. Why is there music playing? Oh. That's not the one I wanted. Alright. I need to call emergency services, but my phone is dead. He's in a bad place. Come on. Call emergency services. Ah, payphone. he's breathing, so that's good. Let's check this guy. He is not breathing. Ma'am, can you hear me? Technically, she should have that information because these would be hardwired in, and it would say, like, payphone this area. CPR mask on and chest compressions. Ready? Here we go. So they say you should be able to do this to the beat of Staying Alive or well, a couple other songs. One ambulance. All right, let's figure out what happened here. William Maddox is hit by Freddy's sports car. The Hamptons car smashes into the sports car. Missing one piece of evidence here. You know what? I bet it is. Yep. All right, so we have all the information. So Freddie Weaver participates in an illegal street race. William Maddox is hit by Freddy's sports car. Tamsin's car smashes it. Oh, no. Sports car stops in the middle of the intersection. And the Hamptons car smashes into the sports car. Hey. William Maddox, in addition to several injuries, the crash broke William's left leg. As a result of poor overall health, William immediately slipped into a coma. His health was so poor that he never recovered from it and died at the hospital 4 months later. Sorry, William, but I tried. Freddie Weaver, your immediate assistants saved Freddie's life. The paramedics were able to revive him on the way to the hospital, where he was charged with causing serious injury by driving recklessly, which eventually resulted in a 10-year prison sentence. Jason Hampton didn't suffer any serious injuries from the accident, was quickly released from the hospital. He soon became interested in Freddie Weaver's case, and some believe his testimony was the main reason for Freddie's unusually high sentence, although no one was able to find any solid evidence. And Bethany Hampton, just like her husband, the accident caused Bethany any major injuries. Just 2 weeks later, she was able to return to work as the mayor's assistant. All right, guys. Well, I believe that's going to do it for this episode. Hope you're enjoying these, because I'm actually really enjoying the game. Put it away. Make sure everything goes where it's supposed to be. All right, perfect. All right, so that's going to do it. Until the next one, this is Jay saying be good, do good, bring happiness into the world. I will see everybody in the next video. Bye.